聚集一起攻打圣徒耶稣。
This is the way it will happen. That's what the Bible says. That's what the
旧约圣经已经预告说这样的事将要临到基督身上。
In other words, it was to be expected.
所以换句话说，这一定我们可以预测得到，它一定会发生。
They must not be discouraged.
所以这些门徒不应该因此而灰心沮丧。
You see, in Psalm 2 there, it says that the leaders of the world were against the Lord and against His anointed, Christ.
在这个诗篇二，刚才我们看的第二十六节里面讲到是说，这个世上的君王一起起来，承载聚集，要抵挡主，并主的受膏者。
And so now, what they were doing to Peter and John, putting them in jail, and warning them not to talk about Jesus, that's exactly what David was talking about in Psalm 2.
所以现在这些宗教领袖，这些撒都盖人把彼得和约翰抓起来以后放到牢里面，他们的目的只有一个，你们要闭嘴，不许再讲这个基督耶稣的这个事儿了。
So this was what was happening was not something that they were, that the disciples were doing. This was something the Holy Spirit was doing through them.
所以我们看见这样的事件不是一个偶然事件，不是说的 彼得和约翰一不小心闯祸了，是圣灵借助彼得和约翰在他们生命当中，要在犹太当中行这样的事。
And the Holy Spirit was guiding them to do this.
而且是圣灵亲自的带领他们一步一步的走到那一步，然后经历这样的事。
You remember at the beginning of that story about the healing the crippled man.
我们记得刚才这故事开始的时候讲什么，他医治了那个瘸子。
Peter saw that the man had faith.
彼得看见这个人对神有信心。
How did he see that?
那请问彼得有什么能耐，他能看见这个人有信心？
The Holy Spirit opened his eyes.
是因为圣灵开了彼得的眼睛，让彼得可以看见这一个瘸子他有信心。
Peter did not use any intelligence that he had.
这彼得不是靠他自己的这个聪明智慧在那里分析来分析去才分析出来了。
But this was after the Holy Spirit had come. The Holy Spirit was in him, and because of that, he was able to see. The Holy Spirit showed it to him.
是圣灵来到彼得里面，圣灵开了彼得的眼睛，让彼得有这么一种智慧，看见啊这个瘸子里面有信心。
And so because the Holy Spirit had showed it to him, he said, "Okay, I have to do it. He has a faith. All right, fellow, stand up."
所以当圣灵开彼得的眼睛，让他看见这个瘸子有信心的时候，圣灵告诉彼得说，你就医治他。所以彼得就定睛看着这个瘸子说，你站起来行走。这人就真站起来行走了。
See, Peter was obeying the Holy Spirit and knowing that the man stands up. That was the Holy Spirit doing. That was not him.
这个所以不是彼得的能力到了这个瘸子身上，瘸子站起来了。是圣灵的能力临到那个瘸子身上，圣灵啊，这个伸出医治的手，让这个瘸子站起来行走。
And so, when the people came running around and thinking that Peter did this,
所以大家刚才可以想象，当所有人亲眼看见彼得行这事的时候，他们到处都很激动，以为是彼得有这个大能，这个神奇是不得了，这个人居然能做这个医治的工作。
He said, don't look at me. I'm nobody. I'm nothing.
这个彼得说你别搞错，这不是我，我哪有这能耐医治这个瘸子呢？
This was not my doing.
这不是我的作为。
This was faith in the name of Jesus who died on the cross.
这是因信靠耶稣基督的名，他死在十字架上，又从死里复活。
God raised from the dead.
他说那个主呢，死在十字架上，神又让他从死里复活。
Implying that now he is in heaven with God.
他实际上是告诉这些人说，这个基督现在就在天上跟神同在。
Believing in him, this happened to this man.
你靠着相信这个耶稣，那死里复活的耶稣，这个瘸子就得到医治。
And knowing and sensing the Holy Spirit with them and guiding them, they had only one thing that they could do is obey what the Holy Spirit led them to do.
所以当一个人看见圣灵的能力，相信圣灵能力降到一个人身上的时候，周围人就可以看见。 这看见的人他们也要领受这种能力，怎么办？只有一条路，就是相信耶稣基督，那死在十字架上神又让他复活的那个基督。
So the disciples then prayed.
所以门徒就聚集在一起为这件事情祷告。
See, like I said before, they realized that this wasTo be expected. This kind of action, the reaction from the world is to be expected.
就像我们前面讲到，这些信徒那已经看见这个眼前的情景，想起旧约圣经里面的预言，他们就知道这一定会发生。
Even from the religious leaders, this is to be expected.
就是从这个宗教领袖这些做领袖的人群当中，他也是会行同样的事，抵挡基督的。
The religious leaders who were preaching, teaching the law, this was to be expected.
这些宗教领袖他们是教法师，他们是在教导以色列人关于神的律法的，但是他们也是在做同样抵挡基督的事。
And verse 28, to do whatever thy hand said, thy purpose predestined to occur. It was to happen. It was something, this kind of a reaction was something to happen.
在第二十八节说，是借着这些什么成就你的手和你的意志所预定必有的事。
Okay, the more we preach the gospel, the more we're going to meet this.
我们越传福音，我们越会面对这样的抵挡。
They went out to preach the gospel, they did not expect people to come around. Oh, that was a wonderful sermon. That was great.
所以当你去传福音的时候，尤其是在不同的场合传福音的，你不能指望说，哦，你传完福音讲完道以后，所有人都一拥而上，像哦，告诉你说你真是了不起，你真是个伟人，你这个信息太好了，我们都喜欢。
You're such a good preacher.
哦，有人说你是个伟大的布道家。
No, they expected the problems, the same problems that David spoke about in Psalm 2.
但是大家记住，真正主的传道人通常碰到的情况是什么呢？就是像在大卫王在诗篇二里所讲的，万国万邦君王起来一起抵挡耶稣。
And so in verse 29, what does he say?
所以在二十九节大家仔细看看这些门徒的祷告是怎么说。
And now, Lord, take note of their threats and grant that thy bondservants or thy slavesMay speak thy word with all confidence.
他这么说，他说主啊，现在求主监察，一面叫你的仆人大放胆量讲你的道。
You see, to speak with, give us the courage to speak with boldness.
他意思就是说，主啊，你给我们胆量，使得我们传道的时候，我们就是刚强壮胆，有这个胆量勇气。
This is the reaction that's going to happen, but.That's not important.
意思就是说，我们去传福音一定会受到这种阻碍和抵挡的，但是这不是什么重要的事。
The important thing is that we have to tell the story.
这个关键在于说，我们必须要把基督死而复活的信息带到这世上去。
Jesus commanded us to do this.
因为基督吩咐我们去做这个。
And so now, Holy Spirit, give us the courage to do it.
所以这些教会怎么祷告？他说：“主啊，求你赐给我们这样的胆量。”
Now you and I have the Holy Spirit if we believe Jesus Christ is our Savior.
弟兄姐妹啊，今天你我就有同样的圣灵，只要我们是信耶稣基督死而复活的。
The same Holy Spirit is in us that was in Peter and John.
这个圣灵在彼得和约翰身上的圣灵。今天就在你我中间。
We have the same commission that Peter and John had.
彼得和约翰所领受的使命，我们也同样领受。
We have the whole Bible with us.
我们有完备的圣经。
We have to ask for boldness for us.
我们必须要求神赐给我们这么一种胆量。
To tell the story.
去传这样的福音。
How many times when there's an opportunity to tell a story, we sort of get afraid?
很多时候我们什么？
We don't know,
有机会传的时候，我们就好像就胆怯了。
We don't know what's going to happen.
我们会想说，哎呦，这个传福音也许会传坏了。
They knew what was happening. They saw it happen.
这些门徒很知道他们将要发生什么事。大卫王说了，后来他们又亲身体验了。
They saw it happen to Jesus.
他们看见耶稣的下场是这样。
They read in the Bible where this is what was going to happen.
他们在旧约圣经里面听到先知不停地说将要有这样的遭遇。
Now this all happened to Peter and John.
现在彼得和约翰也遭遇同样的事。
So they said, Lord, give us boldness that we'll